What's going on, guys? McKenzie Mitchell here, and my guest this week is none other than Toni Storm. Thank you for being here. How are you today?
I'm great. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, of course. Okay, so I, first of all, just have to go ahead and say, you might have the cutest puppy in the entire world.
Yeah.
Please tell me about Ralph.
So I got Ralph about 2 weeks ago, and he's changed my whole life.
Oh.
I'm suddenly a little bit nicer than I was.
Okay.
Yeah, I have love for something now, all of a sudden.
All of a sudden.
And he's just really cute, and he does whatever the hell he wants, and I just let him because his little life.
So he runs your household, basically.
Yeah, he's already become like the dominant one of the house, which is hilarious. But it's just, he's so good to have around. It's changed my whole life. This whole time I needed a dog.
What does Toni Storm do in her spare time?
Right now it's just all about my dog.
Dog, yep.
I like to just sit on the couch and watch funny stuff. Like, I could watch fails all day. I could watch vines all day. It's just...
Are you a TikTok person?
No, it's too modern.
Yeah, I feel you on that one.
It's too new.
I feel you on that one.
It's very good, but I can...
Did you just say vines?
Yes.
TBT. Like...
That's where it's at.
R.I.P. vines. Right?
I wish to see it again, the rise of the vines again.
Right?
Oh my God.
You obviously were living in the UK for quite some time.
Yeah.
How has that transition over to being on NXT on Wednesdays, how has that been?
It's been great, and I think it's been a long time coming. I've needed a change of scenery. I did everything I could in the UK, obviously. And it got to a point where I was like, well, I need new competition, and I need more eyes on me. So I made the move and I came here, and I don't regret it for a second. I certainly won't once I become the new champion.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay, so I don't think a lot of people know this. You were literally days away from moving to the United States, and then life happened.
Yeah, so that was in March of last year. I was ready to go. I had everything packed. Everything was in boxes. I was ready to go. I found out there's travel restrictions and I'm not going anywhere anytime soon. So.
Wow.
WWE said, let's just see what happens for now. We don't know what's going on yet. We're gonna try and get you in. Let's see how it goes. And then in May, they were like, all right, here goes it. Take two. Let's do it. This is gonna be fine. I get my plane ticket. I get rid of my apartment. I pack everything up. I sell everything. Get to London very early in the morning. I get ready for my flight. I'm at the airport and the airline's like, no, sorry. US Customs come out. They're like, no, we're... It's still a no-go. It's not happening, sorry. And I'm like, oh, there's got to be a way. I'm on the phone to WWE, and they're like, yes, we're going to sort this out. This is all good. And one would think it would work out. And I was confident.
Sure.
And then next thing I know, I'm spending 3 days in an airport hotel, like, waiting for the next... We kept trying.
Wow.
And I got to a point where it was like, oh, this isn't happening. This is not... I'm not going anywhere. But I was in London with a suitcase and thought, guess I'm gonna go and crash with some friends. So I did. I was just staying with friends. I didn't know how long I was gonna be doing that for. Luckily, I've got some really cool people that were like.
And how long were you in London?
About 3 or 4 months.
Wow.
I lost track. The days just all turned into one.
It all kind of mushed together.
Yeah,
huh?
And I just would just get up every day like, I don't know.
What am I supposed to do? I'm supposed to be in the United States right now.
I was like, we'll see what happens.
Wow.
Eventually, when I just all hope was lost, WWE called me in August, late August, and was like, might be able to get you in. And then sure enough, next thing I know, I'm standing in Orlando Airport with all my stuff. Like, what do I do now? I didn't think this through. I didn't know this part was going to happen. And ever since then, I've just been building my life out here.
Wow.
And it's been a wild ride, but here I am.
To say the least.
Yeah.
But here we are
here
now.
It's crazy.
So my first guests that I had on the show were Casey and Caden. Mm-hmm. And that was, you know, right before they had their match against you. Unfortunately, you and Mercedes lost in the Women's Dusty Cup.
Yeah.
Do you think you were underprepared going into that match?
No, we were just clearly just screwed over by Io Shirai. And I mean, if it weren't for Io, we would have 100% won that match. There's just so many years of experience between me and Mercedes that it was just like very lucky for Casey and Caden. They got very lucky, and they can thank Io for that.
Well, you just mentioned Io. You will be facing off for the NXT Women's Championship at TakeOver.
Mm.
Are you looking for retaliation there?
Oh yeah. So I've obviously, since the day I came here, it's been my number one goal to become the NXT Women's Champion, and Io is the one person that stands in my way. Thing is, I've already beaten Io before, and I know exactly how to do it again, so now I have my title opportunity that I have deserved this whole time. And yeah, I guess you could say you're looking at the next NXT Women's Champion.
Okay, that's a bold statement.
Yeah, I know. I'm all about that. It's fun. I'm just excited, I guess.
Well, we love watching you kill it weekly on NXT. You are absolutely taking the world by storm and kind of rocking the NXT Women's Division. So we love it. Thank you so much for sitting down with me today. Really appreciate it.
Thank
love
you.
Having you on here. It's always great catching up.
Yes, thanks. Always. Thank you.